Hey there folks, Matt here, and in this power user tip, I'm going to show you how to use the command line interface and keyboard shortcuts to speed up Silkscreen. So you can see here in the command line, I've got a bunch of stuff. It's really just multiple commands chained together. And fundamentally, the command line operates using three steps, one of which is to define the command. The other is to specify the scope. And then lastly is to determine how you want to execute that. The semicolon indicates that you want to do this as one shot. No semicolon indicates that you want to continue in that mode. So in this case, I've got a simple command, same thing I would plug into the command line, but I can map that to a keyboard shortcut. Window and that at symbol there. The at symbol just indicates do something at the current cursor position, but window in that at symbol would center around the cursor. So if you ever wanted to know how to center the screen, that's how it's done. Now, in this case, I've got some options. I can do things like grab a filter created in the design manager. I can run that filter from the command line and go ahead and select all of the vias attached to the ground net. I can also do things like, in this case, place a via and specify that I want it to be a net ground. And again, using the at symbol, I want to place that via at the current cursor position. Likewise, triggering route at that position makes it really easy for me to build a shortcut I can use to fan out signals. I can even do things like specify the width of the track. There's not really limitations as long as it's in the context of whatever the current command is. In this case, makes it super easy for me to fan out the edge connector on a PCI Express board. All right, so let's talk about applying this to Silkscreen. And just quick prerequisite, it's important to understand how the right mouse behaves. When you select a command without anything selected, we call that verb noun. The command is the thing you want to do, the noun, you would select that afterwards. When you select things up front and then you apply a command to them, like move or rotate, if you right mouse, you have the option to apply that to all of the selected items. And this is going to become an important feature of what I'm going to describe in the command line. So let's say that we want to do something like change all the fonts in the design to use a true type font. Now, when I type that in at the command line and I hit enter, you would expect, well, something to happen to all objects. But that's not actually how that command works, because the all objects is applied from the right mouse. In this case, the semicolon is just terminating that, but I didn't have anything selected to begin with. So if I want to do that, but I don't have anything selected, then I use the right caret, and that just indicates trigger the right mouse action. And I just tell it to trigger the right mouse at some location, in this case, 0, 0. And what you see there is that it applies whatever the right mouse action would be. In this case, apply that to all objects. So if I start to chain some other things together here, like align all of the text to the bottom left corner, and change the size of all of the text to 36 mils. Pretty quickly, you can see that I could create a shortcut that cleaned up all of the Silkscreen, regardless of its size, its orientation, its reference point, very, very quickly. Now, this, in combination with the command reposition attributes, is super powerful. Reposition is based on you selecting the component, and it's going to position the selected attribute, name or value, somewhere around the component. So in this case, I've got a bunch of attributes selected. When I trigger reposition and I click on a single component, the action applies to one part. But if I trigger that, applying it to multiple components, I can get all of the text to align to the right locations. So hopefully you can see the power of that combination of shortcuts, using the command line as a way to prototype things, and the reposition attributes command.